was dead. I won that bar. What is useless, little brother?
That's not how you treat your little brother, guys. All hunters miss sometimes. Okay, that's enough for today. Go pack up our stuff, guys. Don't forget to unload your gun. Why did you miss it, son? I saw you lift the barrel on purpose. You missed on purpose. I just couldn't do it, bro. It's so beautiful and hard. I don't feel that I have the right to kill it. It's so painful to kill an enemy.
Richard, you don't have to come with me. Not if you don't want.
I'm sorry, Pa.
Yeah, me too.
I'm really fond of how I feel about hunting. I still feel very sad about the deer Grandpa shot that when we went hunting. I was 8 then. I think I'll write a poem about that incident. After writing about it, I feel less sad now. I don't want anyone to know I write poetry. As it is, everybody thinks I'm strange.
Good morning, teacher.
Good morning, teacher.
Good morning, students. Alright, you may sit down. Today, I would like to start this class with a poem. I think that I shall never see a poem lovely as a tree whose hungry mouth is pressed against the earth's sweet flowing breast, a tree that looks at God all day and lifts her leafy arms to pray, a tree that may in summer wear a nest of robins in her hair, upon whose bosom snow has lain, who intimately lives with rain. Poems are made by fools like me, but only God can make a tree.
See, sister.
I beg your pardon?
My pa says poetry is for sissies. And this sounds like one sissy poet.
I read this poem today because I want you to know that Joyce Kilmer isn't just a poet. He's also signed up to fight for America. I know there are many poets out there who fought in the war. And some of them are even bigger troublemakers than you, Abner.
Hansen, from which book did you read the poem The Trees just right now?
Oh, it's from Trees and Other Poems. You can borrow it.
What's the matter, Hannah? What's wrong?
Yes.
Somebody did a rotten thing with Hannah Sherman's. There are dirty hands all over her books.
Shut up, Richie. Her parents are German. So she's a Hun.
Hannah's parents, they serve sauerkraut, which is Hun food.
But they changed its name to Liberty Cabbage. In the menu, so it will not offend anyone.
The Germans are Huns, they are barbarians. If they won't stop, they will take the world.
It is very unpatriotic to serve a Hun food when a war is going on against Germany.
Yeah, and I really think that the Shermans wants the Germans to win the war.
They talk German too. Maybe they are cooking something that they don't want their neighbors to know.
But guys, being mean to Hannah isn't patriotic at all.
Buddy understands me. I feel alone. I like Mr. Kilmer's poetry. He seems to care about all living things, like me. Should I tell everybody that I write poetry, or should I still keep it a secret? Mr. Kilmer can help me, but he's famous and busy.
Mrs. Hansen, I'm not signing the card. The Shepherds are German spies.
Mrs. Hansen, I was at her birthday party last year, and her family sang the German song, although the war is going on.
Yes, madam. She doesn't even help us with our maths. Quick maths.
She thinks she's better than us.
That's very mean. How could you? A very terrible wrong has happened. And all I'm asking you to do is sign a card.
Do you have to sign the card, Mrs. Hansen?
I can't force you to sign it, but I'll be very disappointed if you don't.
Don't do it, Billy. I'm not going to.
Richie Gang.
Hi, Richie boy.
What do you think you're doing, man?
Yeah, who do you think you are? Are you a hun lover?
Wait, man. I know what you are.
A traitor!
What? Don't call me that. You wanna go home? Come over my dead body, man. Here.
Yeah, game's on.
Fire!
Please, man. Don't hit this beautiful face, man. I won't disturb you anymore, man. Please, man, please. I promise, man.
Hey, don't mess with me.
Hannah? What do you want?
Just brought you this car. I'm sorry for what had happened.
I don't want a car. I wish this had never happened.
Just here to sympathize you.
Most of those people look happy. I wish that I can go to a big city. Nobody will bother me then. But no, I can leave Pa, Gus and Angie in the lodge. Got a letter from New York.
Who is it from?
It's from... Why don't you read it?
I enjoyed your letter, and I sympathize with your predicament. It must be hard keeping your poetic dreams to yourself. You must not let fear of ridicule imprison you and make you deny who you really are. Be strong. I am here at the New York Armory, training to be a soldier. It is very hard work, and I must admit that I am afraid, just like you are. But being afraid is part of life, teacher. We both need to overcome our fears and do what we must do. If you really care about writing poetry, I think you must share your work with people around you. Write me again, and please send me one of your poems. I would like to read it. Your fellow poet, Joyce Kilmer.
Now, who's this Joyce Kilmer?
He's a famous poet who works for the New York Times, I think.
Now, where did he get the idea that you write poetry?
Actually, I wrote to him and I have told him.
Hey, seriously, I've been writing for a very long time.
Just don't let it interfere with your work.
Does anyone here wanna hear it?
I don't think so.
No, thank you.
Never.
Don't tell anyone that you write poetry. Everyone hates you for signing the card for the Shermans.
What? You know about that?
The whole school is calling you a hand lover. I don't want to say it in front of Pa. For your own good, you better start feeling it.
May I come in?
Yes.
Hanson.
Yes. Of course.
Hanson. I just received a letter from Mr. Kilmer.
Okay.
So, I'm afraid to tell anyone that I write poetry. But I don't want to hide it anymore. So this is my best poem. Can you
help me to choose.
Well, let's see. These are some really fine poems, Richard. I'm so proud of you. You got in contact with Joyce Kilmer. Wow. Well, since you are so talented, I want to ask you if you would mind sharing some of these poems to the class. Yes, of course. I think this is your best poem, Thunderstorm.
Richie?
Yes?
I'm sorry, I was rude to you. Actually, it's kind of weird to be the only one who signed in the car. You know, my neighbors, they painted all those awful words yesterday. Yeah, but they promised to prevent it from happening again.
You think perhaps they were just scared?
I was very happy to live here until the war started. My brother Otto had joined the American Army as he's in captured in America. I'm worried if I lose him. And what if he kills his own cousins?
The train is carrying only soldiers this time. But why are they all look so happy? Why don't they seem to think about the danger and hardship that they'll be facing next? I'm worried about Otto and Mr. Kilmer.
You asked about my family, my beautiful wife, Eddie. It's also a poet. We are the parents of 5 children, but one, Bruce, died and went to heaven. My other children are Kenton, Debbie, Michael, and Christopher. Kenton is 9 years old, and I do not think he's much of a poet. But I have told him about my friend Richard, a young poet of the great things. I'm going to North Carolina in August to finish my training, and then I sail for France. I'll write to you again when I can, and I hope that you will write to me as well. I would like to read another of your poems. Good luck and keep me in your prayers. Your fellow poet, Joyce Kilmer.
Mr. Kilmer wanted to read one of your poems, Richard. Have you picked one?
Yes, I did.
Well...
The train is full of soldiers going off to war. The thunder of his wheels is like a cannon stroke. I see the young men's faces as the train goes swiftly by. I see that they are smiling, though some will surely die.
It's so beautiful.
But the last line worries me a lot. I think a nicer ending will be better.
How about Although I Wonder Why?
Oh, I like that. Thanks, Hannah.
I'm happy Mr. Kilmer likes my last poem. I think I'll send him the poem on the train too. But I'll tell him that my friend suggested that last line.
A patriotic program to help sell Liberty Bonds so that we can help finance the war. I'll play the piano while you all sit.
Yay,
of course. And you all also have to write an essay.
An essay
entitled How We Can Help the War Effort Right Here in Turtle Lake. The person, the girl, with the best essay will be chosen as Lady Liberty, and the boy with the best essay will become Doughboy. Remember, this is not a beauty or popularity contest, so everything's fair.
Do I need to join it?
Yes.
Oh my god!
If me become a Lady Liberty, don't you think it's awkward? She is so shy, my dog is not in her.
Oh, Vicky, you win. Mrs. Sensei is just kidding about the essay. You're the hottest girl in this class, okay?
No, but you're pretty too.
But I'm a bit short.
It's better not be me.
Okay, class, most of your essays were good, but for the boys, the best was Richard. So, Richard, could you please read to us your essay? Okay, so for the best for the female students is Hannah. So Hannah, can you come forward and read to us your essay?
Woo! Woo! Go, Hannah!
But may I ask you a question, please?
Yes.
Is Hannah Sherman really Lady Liberty?
Yes, of course.
We need to find someone to replace her. My daughter is better.
What? Oh, that's very nice.
My daughter is kind, you know.
I know that.
How dare a Han girl be a Lady Liberty, huh?
Yes, that's true. Are you out of your mind?
Like,
no, I'm not out of my mind.
I mean, like, my girl is... You know her, like, she's a great actress. How come you took Hannah Sherman? She's from Germany. She's a Han.
Unfair.
Ladies, please calm down. Yes, it's true. Hannah will be the Lady Liberty because she deserves it.
What?
This is more to patriotic.
I know.
But she deserves it because she won the contest fair and square.
Well, class, it seems that Hannah has declined the role of Lady Liberty. So I guess I'll just have to pick a runner-up and let you know in the morning. So let's move on to class.
Hannah, why would you give up the role?
How
Everyone reacted.
But Hannah, you won the contest fair and square. There's no one as smart as you. Don't you want to fight for what you earn?
My father said that there are times to fight and time not to. Right now, there are much fighting in the world already.
You know what? If you're not gonna play Lady Liberty, I'm not gonna play the ball.
No, you shouldn't do that. Don't quit because of me.
My mind's made up. I won't let you go through this all alone.
Thank you, Chi.
So, class, seems like Richard also declined to become doughboy. But it's okay. I already went through all your essays, it's okay. And I already picked the replacements. So,
yay!
The new Lady Liberty is going to be Millie.
Oh,
and the new doughboy is going to be Herbie. So, a round of applause.
And Angie, I'll be home for dinner tonight.
What? People are calling you a traitor and unpatriotic. They say you want the Germany to win the war. But we'll find out about this, more fry.
So, Mr. Sherman, you mean to know any kind of fool? I've heard of the living photograph, Mr. Nobody, and the river.
The river?
Yeah, the river.
The river is actually my favorite.
Yeah, it's pretty popular, you know?
Yes.
Oh, really? Yeah, it's my favorite too. OMG, we're the same, Richard.
What a coincidence. I've been studying in the University of Heidelberg, which really went for vacation. So, I've been for many cities, like New York, London, and Paris, with the Eiffel Tower.
Yeah, I remember when we go over there at the night sceneries are so fantastic.
Yeah, the scenery was really nice.
You should go over there sometime.
Oh, sure. So, we also used to watch many great plays at the Pep Theater, you know?
Yeah, I remember. The senior societies over there are so fantastic.
So, Hannah, how about you tell Richard about Milwaukee?
Oh, Milwaukee.
We need to talk. Richie?
Yes, bro.
I heard that you turned down a part in your school show. Why?
Actually, bro, Hannah wrote the best AC and deserves to be Lady Liberty. But everybody gang up on her. So I refused to be doughboy. I think that's the right thing to do.
Ike Lewis came here to tell me that you did to side with the Shermans. He said that you want the Germans to win the war and that you're unpatriotic.
Pa? No, Pa. I also want the Allies to win. Also the Sherman. The Sherman also want the Allies to win. Your son, Otto, is fighting for Allies in France.
Don't side with the Shermans, Ricky. They are not our people.
Pa, they are also American. They pay taxes like us.
The Shermans have only been here for 4 or 5 years. They are not our people. Remember, Ike helped me to harvest our crops when I broke my leg 3 years ago.
But that's just wrong. Just plain wrong.
Don't be so different, Richie. Perhaps poetry just gives you foolish ideas. fellow poet, Mr. Kilmer.
You know what? I think I will need a scarf to keep him warm and cheer him up. Huh. Then I'll get him some cookies and raisins in them.
One of the buildings there has 50 floors. The elevator rides makes you feel busy. People of all nationalities live here.
Oh, I love to see them. It sounds very fascinating.
Richie, I'm sure you'd love it, Hank. It's like the whole world is on the street.
Hannah, are you thinking about your brother? I'm also worried about Mr. Kilmer and my brother who wants to enlist in the war.
Oh, Richie, I wish we'll never go to war. I wish the war will end soon.
I knew from the first time I stayed for a long time, cause I like me better when I like me better when I'm with you. In this bed next to you, sweet.
Ouch.
What happened, Hannah?
My ankle. I think it's a stone.
Can you take my handkerchief and hold it against your ankle?
Thank
Hi, Pa. Hi, Richie. I enlisted and they took me. I ship out for the basic training tomorrow.
You did what?
The recruiters came to recruit a guy like me after our graduation.
Why did you do that? That's the draft and Uncle Sam may need you. Why join the war when the war's not your concern?
The president says it is everyone's concern and I'm doing my patriotic duty. Don't worry, I won't get killed. I'm too tough and smart for that.
You think you're immortal just because you can play football and you can kill a bug. You're saying that Uncle Roland died in Cuba because he wasn't smart, he wasn't tough.
I don't mean that. I was just saying... I know. You've always tried for your duties here. First, it's on sports. And now it's this war.
Yes. Wait. I didn't mean that. You just took him by surprise.
We are both disappointments. I'm no farmer and I will be. And you, with your poems and dreams, I'm leaving.
Angie, I'm gonna worry about Bob. I think he has a problem and he doesn't want to speak up. He doesn't talk too much lately.
Oh, Michi. Well, you know, Pa, this was the talking type. And I just feel sick thinking of Gus going to war.
Mr. Kilmer likes my last poem. He says, boredom and fear eat away at the souls of many soldiers, but his poetry keeps him alive. He's now writing the rope bucket in the trench. He says, I have to read the works of other great poets and carry on the works of poets like him when they die fighting. But why does his poets play an important role? I don't see that. Poetry are important to the world. All the poems in the world couldn't stop Mr. Kilmer from being killed, and I don't think that they can stop this war. I will write another poem.
A precious world has died. Let children cry, let widows sigh. How could she die, my little world? Until you simply told me why.
Why are you going to leave this school, Richard?
I don't know, sir. I used to send it to Mr. Kilmer, but perhaps I could show it to Mrs. Hansen.
No, that's not enough. Many boys from the 13th Lake are fighting this war right now. Your words will mean a lot to the people on this town who feel like you.
Oh!
Shot. You and I on the court. Time ticking on the clock. Baby, I'ma try to score. Cause you the hottest on the block. Nothing dim in your light. But
with all the options that you got.
Job, I know.
Who'd never treat you right? No, I don't need a telescope to see that you're the one. But I do need your time, and if it ain't yours, I'd rather have none. I don't need a fortune teller to tell me my fortune. I have a million signs that my fortune just begun. You got me jumping like with the jump shot. I'm aiming for you and I won't stop. Back at it again with the jump shot. We could lock it down, never unlock. I said back at it again with the jump shot. I'm aiming for you and I won't stop. Back at it again with the jump shot. We could lock it down only if we gave it a shot.
Someone told me love was only in the movies. It don't exist in my life these days, no. But you showed me if I only just find the faith I need to believe. Anything is possible if you want it bad enough. No, this sky ain't too high, test your limits. You can feel unstoppable, incredible. Almost there, I can see I'm so ready.